seen them for a couple of days.
Yeah, I just wondered how he was getting on, you know.
Well, Di knocked yesterday. See how he's getting on with the kids, you know. Nothing.
I suppose you heard what happened at the funeral.
Grief's a funny thing.
Oh, tell me about it. Do you often?
Inset day.
Right. So, what are you up to here, then?
Actually, I was trying to get on Di's good side by putting this porch up.
What, on your own?
Well, it looks like.
I suppose I could give you a hand.
Mum, are we Jewish?
What?
Elliot says we must be Jewish because we don't eat pork sausage.
We don't eat any sausage.
So are we?
No, we're not. Now, come on, get a move on.
I want sausages, then.
Well, I'll buy you some veggie ones.
Oh, they're not the same.
Josh, we're vegetarian. We don't eat meat.
I'm filming Childline.
Do you want to brush your hair, or shall I sell you to the circus?
Will I have meat?
Josh, hair.
Oh, marvellous. Two great grannies down this morning.
Oh?
Kathy Robinson and that bridey thingy.
What are you going to do?
Well, I was hoping that you could cover.
Me? I'm working at Bev's.
Yeah, but that's not till four, is it?
A small matter of a baby. Unless, Anthea, do you mind looking after Bev?
Of course she doesn't mind.
Ron's got some staff off sick.
Is this instead of working tonight?
Well, no, I'd still need babysitting for that.
Rachel, love, this is family business. Your problems are our problems. Me and Anthea want you to treat us like parents. So if you want babysitting from us, Anthea's only too happy to oblige. Isn't that right, love? Now, if you'll come through here, I'll give you the addresses of where you'll be working.
Thanks a million.
Hi. Oh, I love the coat.
Aw, you're back early.
Yeah. Just to beat the rush hour traffic.
Do you like sausages?
Not just this minute, Josh.
Right, I think we'd better get to school.
I've got a present for you when you get back.
Is it sausages?
Oh, Josh, will you stop going on about sausages? You're driving me mad.
Dave in bed.
He's done one.
I'll tell you about it when I get back, eh? Little pigs had big ears.
Right.
All right.
What's happening?
Pipe burst in the garage is flooded.
Any damage?
Only to me wallet. My day's paid down.
So I'll give you a dropsy.
How's this going?
All right. Could do with an extra pair of hands.
It's me mum in.
You don't have to stay out of her way.
I'm not.
Anyway, she's gone back to work.
Suppose I could give a hand.
Great. You can start by getting us a box of screws. She didn't get an answer either.
We're not the only ones he's ignoring, then.
It's a really weird setup there. Him and his missus.
Ex-missus.
Oh, yeah. Sorry. Do you mind if I ask you something?
Yeah, as long as you don't ask me to marry you.
But didn't all that do your head in?
Too right it did. I hated it when I found out what was going on.
Tell you what, some fellas would have given a hiding for that.
Yeah, it's not my style. I came close to it, though.
Heavy stuff, though.
Yeah, I really messed my head up.
Yeah, I mean, me and Di have our moments, but we've never come close to anything physical like that.
Yeah, you two are lucky. Got some well-mannered kids, a hard-working wife who thinks the sun shines out here. It's perfect. Wish I still had some of that.
Yeah, well, it's not always like that. In fact, at the minute, we're hardly speaking.
All right.
Did you know that I was pregnant?
I'll go make us a cup of tea, shall I?
Hey, congratulations, even for someone your age.
No, hold on. She was pregnant. We lost her.
Oh, yeah. I'm sorry, Matt.
So, at the Mo, we're almost passing notes through those well-mannered kids.
Terrible.
Yeah, so you can imagine my face when I found out how much you'd ripped me off.
Oh, I hope you got the police.
Well, they just ask too many questions, don't they?
So? You don't have anything to hide?
No, of course not.
Well, you shouldn't allow him to get away with it.
Oh, just buy me time.
Do you know where he is?
No, not yet, but...
You should have had him locked up.
Oh, Shelley, you know what it's like. Even if I do get the police, I'm not going to get my money back, am I? And I just have to see him in court. I was really hurt, you know. I miss him. I'm not eating properly. I wake up in the middle of the night, I think he's going to be there, and... Look, I know it sounds really soft, but I'd have him back tomorrow.
But underneath all that charm, there was something bad. And I think you always knew that, Bev.
I wish I could see things coming as well as you do.
What? You mean as well as I saw things happening with Lindsay and Jackie?
Yeah. Don't bring that up. You know how bad I feel about that?
Forget it.
So, this thing's all over then.
Yeah. New Year's resolution. No more Corkills.
And no more Dave for me.
So, just a couple of loose ends to tie up, and then... Oh, I get on with seeing what I'm going to do with the rest of my life.
What's wrong with babysitting?
Nothing, but I like to make my own mind up.
And would you have said no?
I'd have said yes, but I don't like being taken for granted.
I wasn't taking you for granted. I just know that you're reliable, that's all. And like I said, it's a family and we run a family business.
So?
So I don't want to push your nose out of the picture regarding work, so you can still do the great granny's books while you're looking after Beth. I'm going to get the paper.
Won't keep you long. In your case, I might take some time.
I didn't come here to fight you.
Percy?
I just want to talk things over sensibly with you, that's all.
Well, I can't. I've got a customer.
I'll wait.
Wait as long as you like. I've got nothing to say to you. Goodbye.
And I mean that. Not going anywhere.
Max, are you there? Please, will you pick up the phone? I've been around every day, but you never answer, and I know you're still there because my dad's seeing the lights going on and off. Look, I'm getting really worried, and if I have to, I'll get my dad and we'll break in the back. Just to make sure everything is okay. Max, you've got to think of the kids. They need to be out in the fresh air. Look, I'm going to call around later, so... Well, you've got to let me in.
Anyway, can't stand round gassing all day. Give you my regards, OK? Ta-da.
Bye.
You still here? Look, I just want to draw a line under everything that's gone on.
How very convenient.
I mean it.
Yeah, you would joke, you. You come up here, screw up people's lives and apologise. Well, thanks.
It's not as simple as that.
No. We're the simple ones being taken in by a posh bint. Oh, excuse me, you never feel a little bit bitter.
Your mum doesn't want me. As a friend, lover, anything, and I accept that.
That's big of you.
Unless we're going to run into each other from time to time. I think it'd be better if it was more cordial than frosty. Look, I promise you, after today, I won't bother you or your mum ever again if that's the way you want it.
Don't expect me, Mum, to want to even look at you again.
Oh, and I don't suppose you know where Dave got off to, do you?
No, why should I?
Just wondered.
Nice keeper.
Well, according to Leanne, Max went mad, kicked the coffin over. It was a great big fight. All hands in. Lisa Morrissey, your Jackie's fella bailed in. There's people in tears.
Go away.
Yeah, and Max took a swing at the vicar and Mick Johnson.
Well, I can understand them having to go at Mick Johnson. After all, he did nick his missus, didn't he? But you should never try and hit a man on the cloth. Unless he's a Man U fan.
You never change, do you?
Not at my age, dear.
Never too late. You took your life into your own hands going in there, didn't you?
Yeah, I was a bit nervous. Just tying up loose ends.
Sure was.
Too right. You stick to your New Year's resolution. You ditch those Corkill leathers for good.
Well, that was only the first loose end.
Mum next.
Yeah, I don't think Jackie's going to want to see me, but I've got to clear this mess up.
Nervous.
I bet. See ya.
A kid too, you know. And it hurts. I spend every waking hour thinking of it. But she thinks I can't understand, so what worries me is how long she's going to keep this up.
Yeah, well, she'll let you back in. Because it'll soon click that she needs her.
I must admit, that's what keeps me going. Even when things are hard, There's nothing like having a woman who really wants you.
Yeah, I know.
Once in a lifetime, you get the chance to spend the rest of your days with a woman you're really mad about, who's really mad about you. Listen to me getting all maudlin.
I know you. Spot on, mad.
Do you reckon?
It's hard trying to find the right one out there. I've had nothing but bad luck with women.
Hey, there's a good woman out there who's mad about you. You just haven't found her yet. Anyway, I can ask Steve to make us another drink.
Okay. Marty, do you mind if I skip the drink? I need to be somewhere.
Sure. You get off. I mean, all the hard work's done, isn't it?
See you later.
What's the rush?
Anth, have you seen those timesheets, love?
Computer table.
I didn't see them.
Look properly.
Aye, aye. What's all this about, then?
Nothing.
Well, it doesn't sound like nothing to me.
Work it out, then, Mr. Clever Clogs.
What is it? Is it that winter misery thing, that sad?
No.
Well, if it's not that, then what is it? Oh, of course. I'm sorry, love. I understand, honest.
You do?
Yeah. It's the menopause, isn't it?
What?
You don't have to be embarrassed about it, love. Not this day and age, and certainly not with me. New man and all that, I'm well switched on. Look, why don't you get down to the Quacks and get some of that HIT stuff? You know, you can get it in tablets. Better still, get those flesh-coloured patches they stick to your skin. Can't see them under your bikini line or nothing.
I am not suffering with the menopause.
No, well, I am. You've got all the symptoms, the red face, the narcs.
The red face and the narcs, as you call them, are due to frustration.
With what?
You.
Me? What have I done?
You've got no antenna to my needs, have you?
Your needs? Aren't Saturdays enough?
Ron, I'm not talking about sex. My life revolves around this house. I need a job.
You've got a job?
You're based in the house.
Yeah, but you're good at it.
I know that.
All right, then. A pay rise would help.
No, it wouldn't.
Hiya. What's up?
Nothing, love. Nothing.
Ron can't seem to understand that there's more to my life than great-grannies and babysitting.
Anthea, you love babysitting.
On my terms. Oh, I'm sorry, Rachel. I love Beth to bits, but I'm starting to feel hemmed in.
I know what you mean. I only left her with you because I was stuck in a hole.
Oh, and I know you need the money. I'm glad to help out.
So what is the problem, then? She needs a babysitter. And you like doing it?
The Black Forest isn't as dense as him.
Ooh. It's freezing up there.
Get yourself in and get a warm, then. Yeah, look, visitor for you.
So is he. Happy New Year.
Right, if you'll excuse me, I'm going to go and finish getting my gear ready, OK?
What are you doing? I came to apologise. Accepted. Now will you go? Please. Look, while I've been away, I've been over everything and I can't tell you how sorry I am for what I did. Oh, it was ridiculous. You're a married woman. In a marriage that's right back on track. And I'm really pleased about that, Jackie.
Oh, yeah?
Yes. I got it wrong. There's no way you were up for what I was offering. It's taken me some time to come to that conclusion, but I have done.
Is this some sort of a game?
No, I promise.
Oh, thank goodness for that.
You look worn out.
I wonder why.
Can I get you a drink? Stop worrying. It's over.
All right.
Hiya.
I was in the area, Mike, and I thought I'd drop by, you know.
Who are you down here to see?
Oh, an old mate of mine, Sonny Freeman. Looking good, funny. Yvonne.
Looking sharp yourself.
Yeah, well, I've been working with a neighbour. Then I decided to come and see my mate Sonny, and, well...
Didn't have time to change. Drink?
Cup of tea, please.
Wait a minute.
Part of the problem is I didn't really want to live here. It was forced on me because of Captain Mannering's bungled DIY.
So don't you like it here?
It doesn't doesn't feel like my home. None of it. Furniture, decor.
I'll do a changing room then.
Well,
baby's crying.
Right, I'm coming. Ain't the place yours?
Ron.
What have I done now?
Nothing, just listen. How do you fancy a new look?
I'm not down here.
The house.
What's up with the house?
It needs a complete overhaul.
You what?
I won't take no for an answer. And before you say another word, we're having it done by professionals.
Anthea, that would cost a small fortune, darling.
Haven't you worked out the way to a woman's heart yet?
Spend money on her.
Get your chequebook out. We're getting the builders in.
Hi.
Is that right?
It's going to look very good.
Ta. Kids all right, ma?
We're just off to the park. It's the children that keep you going, eh?
You know what?
What?
This is going to sound dead cheesy, but I wasn't really in the area to see me mate, Sonny.
Go away.
Came to see you. See if you fancy going for a...
Go on.
Now, you answer that first, eh?
My mate Hayley.
You're gonna be busy.
Yeah, it's a travel iron. I'm going to Canada.
Well, I mean, Jimmy seems a lot more coherent and happy.
You won't believe how different things are. He's confident, talks sense, and you know, even the other side of the marriage is it's back on track.
Well, you must be very happy.
I don't think I've been this happy in years. I never realised how much Jimmy being ill was affecting me, you know.
Yeah, I remember the strain you were under that night. Sorry.
I was just letting you know that your fancy woman was back. I suppose it was inevitable she'd be round here.
Lindsay, your dad's upstairs.
I know.
Dad!
Lindsay, I'm going. I said that after today I'd get out of your faces, OK?
Lindsay, don't do this to your dad.
Oh. Hi.
Dad?
Yeah?
Just wanted to let you know that the garage is really busy. Could you collect Carly for me, please?
Yeah, sure, no stress. Should have phoned.
I'll walk with you.
OK, see you later.
Bye.
Ciao.
Dad, she knows it would crush him.
Yeah. You haven't known her very long, have you? You've got her sourced.
I'm just so glad everything's, thanks, sorted out between us at last.
Better like this.
Yeah. I haven't slept in weeks.
Neither have I.
Do you think Lindsay will ever forgive us?
Oh, she'll probably forgive me. It's a pity it turns out like this. We were good friends once.
Look, I just want you to know that I never engineered that situation to get you into bed. It just happened. Bye.
Shelley. Thanks.
What for?
That night when I needed comforting. I'm glad that you were around for me, and thanks. You were there for me, and I won't forget that.
So, 6 weeks, eh?
Yeah. I haven't seen our Lois for years. She keeps on at me to go out, so...
You're going.
Well, there's nothing to interest me here.
There's me.
want a woman. You want one-night stands.
I came round here to ask you for a date.
There you go. Another one-night stand.
Could turn into something.
Do you want that?
I'm going to miss you.
You don't see me often enough to miss me, Mick.
I said, I'm going to miss you.
I'll miss you too. I've got a plane to catch.
I wish.
I'm just going to collect Josh. How did that other loose end tie up?
Oh, knotted and finished.
Oh, all right. What did she say?
Well, she was actually a lot more forthcoming than I expected.
Go on.
Well, I called around to see her, and she was a little bit anxious at first, but she settled down. And then Lindsay came home and got off again, and Jackie and I were alone.
Oh, why?
And then I turned to go, and she called me back and thanked me for what happened that first night.
She thanked you?
Yeah. I really think she meant it, Bev.
Hang on. So she says ta-ra, then she calls you back and she thanks you for the big leather night you had together?
Yeah.
And you reckon that's all over?
Yeah, well...
Shelley, when me and Dave finished, if I'd have called him back, he'd have known it wasn't over, wouldn't he?
Yes, but...
And it's exactly the same with her. She wants to keep things going.
I don't think so.
She just can't tell you outright, that's all.
You really think she didn't want me to go, then?
I reckon Jackie Corkill is a closet lesbian. Now, you should know this more than me. And from what you tell me, it sounds like she's got feelings for you. Maybe deep ones. All the signs are there. There is no way this thing is finished.
Oh, about 2 seconds ago.
Not only have I got the best family a man could ever want, I've got friends as well.
Don't worry about me, Mystic Meg. I can take care of myself.
The way he was carrying on at that funeral, it wouldn't surprise me if he did anything.
I think we both know why you're here.
Well, hoping for kisses and close encounters with complete strangers, Davina sets him up for an evening of delight or disaster. Street Mate is next here on 4.
To go back in.
Don't be worrying, love. It's just routine.
I know. I just can't understand why they can't sort you out at home without readmitting you.
Standard procedure. Mm. Anyway, it's only for a week.
Yeah, I suppose you're right.
Oh, where's my toothbrush? I must have forgotten it.
Shall I go for it?
No, you're all right.
Oh, I'll get it.
Hi. Who were they for?
They're for you. And Lindsay.
Why are you bringing us flowers?
It's a peace offering.
Where did you get that?
Oh, about 2 seconds ago. My head's still spinning.
Watch that. Duty free, if you ask me.
Oh, I want to know all about Fred. Tell me all the details.
Where do I start? It was 10 days of sheer, unadulterated bliss.
You mean you were at it all the time?
Bev, do you mind? He's my brother. I'd rather not know about things like that, thank you.
You're only jealous.
Oh, we weren't apart for more than a few minutes the whole time. It was dead romantic.
Oh, more romantic than watching a sunset in Manor Park.
Even that would be special. But Fred was sitting next to me.
Bless.
He's a man in a million.
Not many of those about anymore.
And seeing him again, well, it helped me make up my mind.
You're not thinking about moving over there, are you?
No, no. I'm going to get Fred over here.
Far be it from me to burst your bubble, but didn't they turn him back at the airport last time?
Yeah, but, well, there's got to be a way. And I'm not going to stop until I find him.
Ah, oh, not again.
So are you?
Some tight gets gone and ripped out the last page.
Is that all?
Yeah, well, not all of us have got visitors, have we? Books are about the only distraction I've got in here.
Yeah, well, that's just too sad for words, if you ask me.
You got your bear coming today?
Yeah, how'd you guess?
You've been gazing at that thing all morning.
Do you think it's too much?
Nah, I'm only messing. You look gorgeous.
I can't wait. I'm going to get in that visiting room nice and early and bag one of those corner tables.
Why is that?
Because if you're not right onto some screw's nose, there's less chance of getting disturbed.
All right, yeah.
You've got a lot to learn about women, you know, Toto. And you're not going to pick it up from those old manky books. Well, not those ones, anyway.
There's no need, you know. Oh, I wanted to. What's going on?
Oh, I love.
Ireland. Never mind all that. What are you doing round here? And what's with the flowers?
Shelley brought them as a source of peace offering.
Oh, she did she?
I can't find that toothbrush anywhere. I don't believe it. It's in my case all the time. Better not tell the edge string about that at the Aussie. Had I, eh? They might not let me out again. Hello, love. What are you doing in this neck of the woods?
I'm beginning to wonder.
Shelley brought you some flowers? I was just going to pop some in water.
Oh, why for me? Thanks, love. I'm touched. That's you all over, isn't it, girl? Hey, I was thinking about this family. What have we ever done to deserve you, eh?
It's nothing, really.
Hey, come on. Credit where credit's due. And you can forget about putting them in water. I'm taking these with me.
To the hospital?
Yes, too right. Because every time I look at them, they will remind me of the one thing that's going to get me through all this.
What's that, Jim?
Not only have I got the best family a man could ever want, I've got friends as well.
Must have made a real fool of myself getting up in front of all those people like that.
Max, you're upset.
That's maybe, but I mean, didn't warrant me saying all those things, blaming everyone for what happened to Susanna. Apart from myself, of course.
Yeah, well, there's no point going over it all again, is there?
I suppose you're right.
You'd be better off looking to the future rather than driving yourself mad with what might have been.
Well, I don't think there is any future for me.
See? There you go again. Max, you've got to stop thinking like that.
Oh, I'm really sorry, but it just seems to be one thing after another at the moment, that's all.
Has Harry and Emma been playing off?
No, they've been fine. It's work that's been the main concern. Been getting on my back at the amount of time I've been taking off.
But you're entitled to leave, aren't you?
Well, yeah, it's not as simple as that. I'm freelance. I mean, if I'm not available for work...
Well, can't you have a word with them, explain the circumstances?
Yeah, I did. And, although they've been very understanding about it, I think they're beginning to lose patience.
Oh, Lance, the lovely.
Oh, and they were worth the money just to see your face. Hope they have legs here, present. Didn't have much left after getting you those.
What'd you get her?
And one of those snowstorm thingies. You know, with a mermaid in it. Turn her upside down, she sheds her scales.
Yeah.
Oh, well, it was a panic buy. But watch out, the lady who's got everything.
Well, maybe not everything. But Dave's done one.
A runner?
1 minute he was here, next minute gone. And he's not been seen since. Oh. Between me and you, I don't think he's coming back either.
When did this happen?
New Year's Eve.
Oh, where is she? I better go and see she's all right.
So steady on. There's plenty of time, Lance. I'm not even sure she'd want me to tell you.
Yeah, you're right. I should approach this with caution. So what happened? Did they have a row, yeah? Was there another woman?
I don't think so. Mind. Not a day went by in here that he wasn't undressing me with his eyes.
Never said anything.
Happens to me all the time, Lance. It's a cross that I just have to bear.
Thought it was you.
Well, you were right.
I'm glad I caught you, actually.
Not another medical emergency, is it?
I don't think so.
So what was so urgent?
Well, I was wondering if you had any plans for tonight.
Let me see. George Clooney's meant to be popping over for a drink tonight, but I can easily put him off till next week.
Well, maybe I could come round instead, then.
Oh, you could you? Your hectic social calendar would allow that.
Look, it's not easy for me asking like this, you know.
Go on, then. but the entry price of the pizza in a video.
Sounds good.
So if you don't mind me asking, where's Nikki going to be tonight?
She's going into town with some mates from uni.
Leaving you all on your lonesome?
Well, I could have gone, but all they'll do is spend half the night talking about coursework and... But it does me heading after a while.
Sounds like one of our staff nights out.
So no talk about work, then?
I don't think there'll be much talking at all, do you?
Lance, he made a show of himself.
Oh, the funeral.
Well, where else? He got up in front of everyone.
Well, what were you doing there in the first place?
Well, I was representing the bar. I mean, she spent enough time in here, didn't she?
Oh, yeah. I suppose you're right.
Well, anyway, he started spouting all this stuff about how no one gave a toss about her. And then he called us a big bunch of hypocrites for being at the funeral. I mean, I hardly knew the woman.
Well, it must have been shock. Oh, poor fella. Didn't anyone try and comfort him?
You're joking, aren't you? The coffin went over then there was this big riot and... Lance, I was lucky to get out alive.
Oh, go away.
Why? It was boss. I mean, it was terrible.
He'll be in bits. Maybe I should go and see how he is.
Why?
Because he's a mate, and he let us stay in his flat when we had nowhere else to go. I
suppose. Still think he's mad if you'd ask me.
I'll see you later.
No, this one's reserved.
Shh, not your bird?
Yeah.
So you are. I'd have two, I'd give her one.
Don't fancy yours much.
I have not missed you.
Not as much as I've missed you.
Do you want a bet?
Does anyone fancy a cup of tea?
No, sir.
I didn't think so.
Hey, mate.
All right, Jack.
Can I have an orange, please?
Yeah.
I thought you'd be sweating over a hot cooker in the restaurant.
Just having a quick breather before the rush really starts.
Busy?
I'm not so much busy as understaffed.
Get someone in, you'll get mad chance to do it all yourself.
Oh, Jack, but it's fine if someone with the right experience, that's the problem. I mean, you can't just pick the first person you run into. A lot of responsibility involved, you know.
Well, have you called the job centre?
Yeah, hardly at the time. Anyway, what I really need is a mate of thee. And I don't think the job centre can help me.
I think I might know someone.
I'll tell you what, Jack, after the morning I've had, all suggestions are gratefully received.
Well, he's good with people and he's trustworthy and he's done it before.
That sounds great. Who is it?
Max.
Max? I don't know, Jack. I mean, you think that's a good idea?
Well, he said you needed someone with experience.
Do you think he'd want to do it?
Don't see why not. I mean, he's not getting much surveying work at the moment and he needs the money.
I mean, it might work.
Yeah, of course it would. Hey, with your cooking and his charm, there'd be no stopping you.
I'll tell you what, I'll think about it.
Brilliant.
That's not a definite yes.
Well, he's in this afternoon. You could nip over on your way home.
I'm not going to hear the last of this until I ask him, am I?
Ah, you're catching on quick.
I just can't believe you're making such a big deal about a bunch of flowers.
Admit it. They were for my mum.
Oh, well, what if they were?
You admit it then.
Look, it's not a hanging offence buying some flowers, Lindsay.
Shelley, what are you up to?
I'm not up to anything. Your mother's had a hard time of it lately.
Yeah, most of which has been down to you.
Yes, I know. And I was trying to apologise for pursuing things when I know I shouldn't have.
Can't you just leave her alone?
Well, Jackie's managed to accept my apology anyway.
Oh, good for her.
And we're going to stay friends, whether you like it or not. Now, if you don't mind, I've got things to be getting on with.
Don't worry, I'm going.
Not as bad as they make out. The only thing I really hate, though, is getting banged up at night.
This could have been me.
Yeah, well, I'm glad it wasn't.
So am I.
So, anyway, how are things at home?
Not too bad. I might be getting my job back at the salon.
How did you swing that?
I haven't yet. But, Shella said she's going to have a word today and for me.
Well, isn't she still mad at you for us robbing a house?
Oh, I think she's got over it now. Besides, she made out like a bandit on the insurance, didn't she?
Is Leo in there, you know? still.
I think so, yeah. Makes me sick thinking about it.
Yeah, same here. She's definitely a two-bag job.
What?
Well, you need one bag for her head and also another one for your own in case hers falls off. So do you think she'll be able to convince Diane?
Well, it's worth a try, isn't it?
So why all this sudden interest in working for a living, anyway?
Well, we're going to need money if we're going to get married, aren't we, soft lad?
Married?
Yeah. Unless you can think of another way that we can be together without everyone sticking their oar in.
Not just a pretty face, are you?
Everyone just noticed. Oh, and don't say nothing to me, Nan or Nicky. I don't want anyone finding out.
Of course. But what you earn in the salon, it's not going to keep us, you know.
So, how was the funeral?
I expect Leanne told you what I did.
Yeah, she did mention something.
I don't know what came over me. I suppose I wanted people to know what Susanna was really like.
Hey, it was a very emotional day. You should see me at weddings. It's a three-hanky job.
I can't help feeling that I let her down. I wanted people to remember her. The only memory they will take with them is me making an idiot of myself.
Max, you know, people are more understanding than you think. Hey, Arlie-Anne was only saying this morning. What you said, well, it had an effect on her.
Yeah, that's nice of her.
At least now you've got her out of your system. You can move on. Start to focus on the future.
I don't think I can.
But you're going to have to, for the sake of those two kids, if nothing else.
I can't seem to shake the memories. Susanna dying. So young. She had so much to live for.
You know, it doesn't surprise me that you're still haunted by her.
Oh?
I mean, here you are, living in the house you used to share with her, surrounded by all her things, seeing the people who knew her day in, day out. But it's bound to have an effect on you.
Maybe you're right. Tongues will be wagging her. Yeah, especially after the funeral.
I'll stick the kettle on.
For one more minute.
They'd be locking me up with you. Don't go now.
Yeah, well, I wouldn't be complaining.
I bet you wouldn't.
Look, I hate to break you two up, but you better be making a move.
I'm coming now.
Take care of yourself, lad.
Don't be worrying. I'll be fine.
And I tell you what, as soon as you get out of here, we're going to be throwing the biggest party that Close has ever seen.
Is right, lad.
Is right, lad.
Funny messing.
You can catch me up, all right?
All right, thanks, Jen.
I'll see you later.
Are you going to write to me before the next visit?
Promise.
Tell you what, Sinead, your bird's a stunner.
Yeah, she is.
What's her name again?
Emily.
Most blokes would kill for a bird like that.
Yeah, well, they wouldn't get a look in.
You can see that. She looks right into you. Like I said, unlucky lad.
You really miss her, don't you?
Been thinking about what you said. About making a fresh start.
And?
Maybe you're right. It's time to move on.
It's the only way.
I hate that place.
I think that's the point. It's not meant to be a battle of laughs.
Oh, at least we get to leave. I can't imagine what it must be like for Tim, being locked up 24/7.
No wonder people go after Ed as soon as they get out.
You don't think he will, do you?
Nah, Tim's got his head screwed on.
I can't wait for him to get out. We're going to start again. Put all that behind us. Do it right this time.
Have you told him about your new modelling career?
You're joking, aren't you? He hates that car.
But I thought you two didn't have any secrets.
Yeah, you know what they say. Some things that people don't know won't hurt them. Besides, we need the money for when he gets out.
I guess you're right.
Sam, have you got any secrets from Nicky then?
Me? Don't be soft.
Should have seen him. He was in a right state.
No, thanks. Saw enough of him at that funeral to last me a lifetime. Do you know what, Lance? I really cannot stand men. I love them.
I thought he'd be getting back to normal by now, but it seems worse of anything.
Well, that's guilt if you'd ask me.
How'd you make that out?
Well, I'm no psychologist, like, but the way he was carrying on at that funeral, it wouldn't surprise me if he did any.
Leanne, pal, take that back right this minute.
Keep your tan on, Lance. I was only messing.
Well, don't. That's how rumours get started. Anyway, what is the matter with you? You've been in a right knock since I got back.
I lost some money, didn't I?
Oh, well, I've warned you about those horses.
Well, it's this lad in the bookies. He said he had a building society job. He must have had three legs and a cough.
Didn't win, then.
Still going around the track.
Yeah, well, that's no excuse for saying horrible things about Max.
Sorry.
Where's your dad?
How is he?
Seems fine.
I'll go and see him tomorrow.
He'll like that. He thinks the world of you, you know.
It's a shame the same can't be said for you.
How can you say that?
Because it's true.
So that's it, then. I make one mistake.
If it was a mistake, things would be different. You knew exactly what you were doing.
I didn't.
And you're very good at playing the martyr, I'll give you that.
Oh, well. There's nothing more to say, then, is there?
I live over there, remember?
There's no need to be sarky with me. I was only asking because Nicky's an RC, me nan.
Yeah, and after that, she's going into town with Bernie.
Oh, jealous, are you?
No, got me own plans for tonight.
Slouched in front of the footy with a lager, yeah?
Yeah, how'd you guess?
Just knew what men like. Look, thanks for giving me a lift.
No sweat.
See ya.
See you later.
You have to pick up the kids, then?
Yeah, I'm running late as it is.
It's all right, it won't take long.
All right, that sounds ominous.
No, no, don't worry, it's nothing heavy. It's just that I've got a proposition for you.
How'd your visit go?
Sound.
Bagsy the corner table?
Too right.
Wish I had more visitors.
Yeah, well, it's a good thing you're not going on Millionaire. They'd only give you two lifelines.
Cheers.
Hey, I was speaking to that Soto one. I've changed my mind. He's not such a div.
You're joking me, aren't you?
No, he seems all right.
I wouldn't trust him as far as I could throw him.
So, he's giving you a hard time. That's only because you don't know how to stand up for yourself. As soon as I stuck a fork in his hand, he knew who was boss.
Listen, take my word for it. He's a sly get. Don't let your guard down.
You're like an old woman, you. Always moaning at something. You want to listen to yourself?
I'm only saying, be careful.
Don't worry about me, Mystic Meg. I can take care of myself.
So, do you fancy a beer?
Yeah, nice one.
I've actually only got lager, is that okay?
It's fine. I didn't really come round for the ale anyway.
Oh, so what did you come round for then?
Look, Nisha, I came round because it's easier than staying away. I mean, I've never felt like this about anyone.
Jerome, save the speech. I think we both know why you're here.
Oh, I've never seen a bloke as in love as Lance, you know. Must be something to this same-sex thing, after all. Oh, don't tell me you're thinking of converting as well. Oh, you must be joking. My love life's already a disaster without any more complications.
Oh, you must be devastated.
Oh. More angry with myself than anything else, really. I should have seen it coming.
You're in love?
They say love is blind, I suppose. Speaking of which, how are things with Jackie Corkill?
She's coming around, I think.
Back on, then?
Not as such. But I think it's just a matter of time. I mean, according to Jackie, things between her and Jimmy are just fine.
But
I think she's just saying that out of loyalty.
Has she given you any hints that she might be interested?
Not in so many words. Yeah, I just think she just needs a bit more time to come to terms with how she feels. It's a big step for her.
And how about Lindsay?
Well, I've told her that Jackie and I intend to stay friends, and she seems to have accepted that.
And if you become more than mates?
Then she'll just have to learn to accept that too, I suppose.
So what do you think? Me as a head chef, you as a maitre d', could be a winning combination.
I must say, it does sound interesting.
So?
I've been giving things a lot of thought, and I've decided I need a fresh start.
Well, that's exactly what this would be, Max.
It's not exactly what I had in mind, though.
Oh, just give it some thought, eh? I mean, there's no big rush.
No, no, that won't be necessary. I thought it best to hear you out first, because I appreciate the offer.
All right, well, don't worry about it, Max. I mean, I'm sure I'll find someone. I understand you wanted to stick with the surveying.
Probably pays more anyway. It's just with it being Susanna's place, you know, I thought.
Oh, that's not the reason why I'm turning you down.
Why is it, then?
I've decided to get away.
What, take a holiday?
No, I'm taking the kids and I'm getting out of Liverpool. For good. I've decided to move on.
Things aren't right between Ed and Lindsay, and it feels like they're hiding something from me.
You decide to take Harry away and you don't even think to let me know.
He made a mess of filming the wedding.
Made a mess up when you make a mess, it's simple.
Why are you torturing yourself over a marriage that died a very long time ago?
My marriage is alive and well.
And Brookside is back tomorrow at 8 o'clock. Well, next on Four, it may be midwinter, but Driven is going topless, road testing a trio of sports cars.
Your favourites. Little Pretty to cheer you up. Are they in the little sugar bunnies here?
No, they're in nursery.
Oh, probably helping Trona finish a jigsaw puzzle. Oh, bless.
Oh, did you find yourself a holiday bargain on Teletext?
No. I've decided to move on.
You're leaving?
Well, you said yourself, too many bad memories around here to stick around.
Yeah, but gone just like this, it's so sudden.
If I don't leave now, I never will.
I feel like I should try and talk you out a bit. But I realise it's for the best.
The sooner we leave, the better.
Hi, Jim.
Oh, Shelley.
How are you?
Oh, not so bad, yeah. What are you doing here?
Thought I'd come and see you.
It's hard fitting your whole life around hospital visiting hours, isn't it?
I really look forward to it. It seems as soon as I get back from one visit, I'm getting ready to go to the next one.
Set up his home soon, eh?
Yeah, I can't wait. He hates being there. I don't half feel sorry for him.
Well, I'm sure seeing you and this lovely little one will cheer him up.
We've got a surprise for him today, haven't we? She started walking.
He's a clever girl, isn't he?
He's growing up so fast, I can't believe it. Are you?
You going in to see Mike?
Yeah.
Do you want a lift?
Oh, no, it's fine. The bus stop's right outside the hospital.
I've got nothing else to do.
Hey, it's a lift, love. Take him up on it before he changes his mind.
It's no problem, honestly.
Well, Mike will be glad to see you.
I won't go in, Emma. I'll just drop you off, eh?
Oh, go on. He'll be made up to have someone to talk football with.
What do you reckon to that?
Very nice. Jackie's not the only artist in the family, then.
Yeah.
The doctor said I should draw whatever comes into my mind. Like it's going to give him some sort of insight into what's going on in here. I tell you, if I started drawing all sorts of weird things, he'd be scared to let me out. To stay in here for as long as I like.
You seem like your old self again, Jim.
Yeah, I am. I'm getting there, you know. I feel as if I'm ready to go on. They just want me to finish off the care programme, you know.
Jackie will certainly be glad to have you back.
Yeah, I hope so.
Of course you will.
Things aren't right between Ed and Lindsay, you know. Feels like, I don't know, they're hiding something from me.
You're just imagining things.
I'm not. They're putting on a front for my sake. But I can sense the tension between them.
Are you sure you don't mind?
Of course not.
Oh, it's dead kind of you, thanks.
All right, where are you off to? Never mind me. What was all that about?
I'm just giving Rachel a lift to the Aussie.
What is up with you, eh?
It's only a lift.
Look, I've told you, you've got to stay away from me.
Well, Katie offered, what could I say?
Yeah, well, make sure it's the last time. I'm telling you, steer clear after this. I'll see you later.
Hiya.
Hiya.
When are they off?
I can just give Rachel a lift to the Aussie.
Oh, that's nice of them.
Yeah.
So, what are you up to?
Just go and see if you fancy a drink later.
Oh, yeah, sure. Well, I've got a few things to do, but I'll meet you when I'm finished.
All right, Sandy.
All right, Jack. Hey, Robbie. Yeah. Have you got any change in the health club saving me going to the bank?
I've got none to spare, sorry.
Oh, as if I've got enough to do, you know.
Had a chance to speak to Max about that job yet?
Well, yeah, he said he'd take it if he wasn't getting off.
Getting off? Well, where to?
I don't know. He just said he wanted to get off with him and his kids get away from here. Can't say I blame him either.
Yeah, but he can't.
Well, his mind seemed pretty made up when I spoke to him, Jack. Anyway, see you later.
See ya. I can't believe Max is just getting off like that.
Yeah, well, it's probably for the best.
Well, I don't think it is.
Because he's taking Annie with him?
Well, yeah. I won't see him if they move away.
Well, there's nothing you can do about it.
Look, I'm going to go round there and see him, see what's going on. See you later.
I haven't been a proper husband to her for God knows how long. She needs someone she can rely on, someone who's there for her.
Jimmy, you've had your problems, yes, but you're still close.
Are we? I feel like we're drifting apart. Sometimes I think she deserves better than me. She deserves love, companionship.
And she gets that from you?
No, not for a long time. After everything I've put her through, it's a wonder she hasn't dumped me.
She wouldn't do that.
I can't help thinking she'd be better off without me. Perhaps she deserves someone else. I don't know. Someone who can give her all the things she deserves. Things that I can't. I'm sorry, love. You didn't come here to listen to me witching on about my marriage falling to bits, did you?
I don't mind. Jimmy, if you need to talk, I'm here for you.
You've been a good friend to us, Shelley. Coming here to see me. Looking after my Jackie. And you've been a good mate to our Lindsay. I really appreciate everything you've done.
I can't believe you're actually going.
Hey. You will come back and see us, won't you?
Well, I'm not making any promises. I feel like I should be making a clean break. Coming back here would bring back all those memories.
Mm-hmm. I'll get it.
Excuse me, is he in?
I don't think he wants to see anyone.
So it is true, then?
Did Mick tell you?
It would have been nice to hear it from you.
No, I'm sorry.
Were you just going to get off without telling me?
No, I'd have been in touch.
Oh, that's nice of you. You decide to take Harry away and you don't even think to let me know.
Thank you.
thinky, clever little girl walking.
Brilliant.
We bumped into Clint in the garage and he offered to give us a lift.
Nice one.
Come on, take a seat. At least you've got someone to talk footy with today.
I try my best to be a good husband, but I just always seem to mess it up.
I'm sure that once you're back home, Jim, things will be back to normal.
Normal? I can't even remember what that is.
Things really been that bad for so long?
It seems like.
But you still love each other?
Not in the same way. There's no passion anymore.
You mean in bed?
Now you are going back in time.
Do you and Jackie, you don't? Well, you do still sleep together.
Well, we spend the night in the same bed. Most of the time, anyway. We just don't.
Really? Well, there's more to love than sex, Jim. I mean, do you still hold each other?
There isn't even much of that these days. We used to be dead affectionate. Couldn't keep our hands off each other. Even years after we were married. We've had our ups and downs, mind you, but even through that, the physical side of things was always great. Not anymore, though. Not for a long time.
I can't believe you're serious about going. I bet you haven't actually thought it all through properly, have you?
Oh, of course he has. And it was a hard decision, so don't go trying to talk him out of it.
Yeah, but I know he's making a mistake, all right?
I can't stay here, Jackie.
Oh, and where are you going to go, Off to the high seas playing Popeye again? I don't think so, Max, not with two little kids.
The children will be fine. We'll probably move down south somewhere. Maybe somewhere in the countryside.
But what's wrong with round here?
Nothing, apart from all the painful memories. Look, I don't want him to go either, but we can't expect him to stay just to keep us happy.
Please, will you just keep out of this? I want him to stay for real reasons, not just because his picture's been up on some billboard.
It's all right, Lance. She's just upset, that's all.
Yeah, well, I've got to go anyway. I'll be late for work. I'll pop by later, see if you need any more help. You. Ooh. You're a nasty piece of work. I don't know why me and Arlene are the only ones who can see it.
Please, Max. At least think about what you're leaving behind. You know, you're all set up here. Your kids live in a nice house and you've got good friends and neighbours. Why turn your back on it all?
And what about when the children are old enough to ask about the mother? I can't tell them that this is where it happened. We can't stay here knowing that this is where she died.
Yeah, but surely that's a reason to stay. To be near her memory and Matthew and Emily. My dad always wanted to move back in next door because it was our Tony's home when he died.
We'd never be happy here. And I don't want the children growing up sensing that. That we've got to go.
But running away isn't the answer.
Why can't you see it from my point of view?
I can, but I know that it's the wrong decision.
Why? Because you don't want to lose touch with Harry.
No. This isn't just about Harry. It's about you as well. Our friendship. I'd miss you too.
Really?
Yeah. You're a good mate and I don't want to see you making a mistake. You're giving up too much. Please, at least think about staying.
I'm sorry, Jackie. I've made up my mind. We've got to go.
Been here by now. Said she was going to try and call in.
Maybe she's been delayed or something. Mm. Anyway, I better get going, Jim.
Oh, right. Listen, thanks for coming, Shelley. You're a mate, do you know that? Sorry if I went on a bit.
You didn't. I'm really glad I came. See you, Jim.
See you, love.
No matter how hard you think things can get, you can deal with them, I know you can.
Well, you obviously have more faith in me than I have.
I'll help you through it.
You say that now. You've got your own life.
Yeah, and you and the kids are part of it, and I want it to stay like that. However hard things get, I promise you, I'll help you deal with it.
Oh, yeah?
Hiya, love. Knew you'd be in.
Got you these.
Oh, thanks.
Oh, been chasing yourself?
No, I've had a visitor.
Oh, yeah.
She's a cracker and all. I tell you, my reputation in this place has gone sky high.
Who was it then? Jessie Chadwick?
No.
Shelley. I reckon she's jibbing all that leisure stuff. She fancies someone older to help us swap sides. I'm only messing.
I know. As if she'd even look at you.
Thanks.
So what did she have to say for herself?
Well, not much, really. It was me doing all the talking. I really opened up to her. It's like having a good old session with the psychiatrist, only better.
Right, I'll go and get her some chocolate buttons or something.
Ah, oh, thanks. Any nice?
Oh, yeah.
Why are you being so horrible?
Why did you have to bring him in with you?
Well, I thought you'd be glad of a visitor. What's up with you? You didn't even make a fuss of Beth.
Well, how would you feel? Lying paralysed, watching your daughter walk for the first time, holding somebody else's hand.
I'm sorry. I thought you'd be pleased she was walking.
I am. But being like this is driving me mad. I'm no use to anyone.
Of course you are.
I can't even provide for my own wife and daughter. And the longer I'm like this, the more debt we're going to be in.
You'll manage.
You will, you mean? I'm not doing anything to help out.
Well, you'll be back on your feet soon. And then you can go back to work and start up the video business.
How long's that going to be, that way? Have Ray and Jessie coughed up for the wedding video yet?
No.
Well, you're joking. The minge bags. I'll get my dad to go round later and collar them.
He can't.
Why not?
There was a bit of a problem.
Well, I thought you said it went fine.
Well, I didn't want to upset you.
It's me dad, isn't it? What's happened? Has he lost the tape or something?
No.
Well, what then?
He made a mess of filming the wedding.
Made a mess? How can you make a mess? It's simple.
Every time he pressed the record button, he was pausing it, and when he thought he was pausing, it was recording. He felt really bad about it.
What, like £200 bad? Did he get any of the wedding?
Ray and Jessie weren't very happy.
Oh, well, that's it then, it's all over.
Will you be able to get more work?
Well, what's the use? The whole thing has been a disaster from the start. I mean, that equipment's lying there doing nothing. At least if we sell it, we'll have some money for the next few months.
It's gonna be difficult leaving this house. Must be so many happy memories here too.
There are, yeah.
Susanna wouldn't want you to leave, would she?
No, I suppose not.
No matter how hard it was for you, she'd want Harry and Emma to stay in their own home, wouldn't she?
Well, I know, but it's not as simple as that.
But Max, they'd be better off here, and so would you.
But I know I can't.
I'll help you through it. Together, we can make sure that you can cope. Believe me, no matter how you feel now, going away is a big mistake. You'll only end up regretting it.
What if I regret staying?
You won't. I promise I will always be here for you.
However bad things get?
I can give you all the support you need. We can do it. For the kids' sake and yours.
Be right with you.
You're getting around today, aren't you? Gonna drop in on Lindsay later as well.
You've been to see Jimmy then?
Yeah, he's my husband. What is he to you exactly?
Someone that I happen to really like. And he's really worried about you. So am I.
Well, don't be. I'm fine.
Jimmy's fine, so just leave us alone.
Well, now, Jimmy didn't really seem to think so. He said things weren't going so well between you.
That's none of your business.
And they haven't been for a long time, have they?
Thanks for your custom.
Why are you torturing yourself over a marriage that died a very long time ago?
My marriage is alive and well.
Now, how can it be when you don't even sleep together anymore? Where's the love? Where's the passion?
Just get out and leave my family alone.
You deserve more, Jackie. Far more.
I saw Jackie before with Robbie. They seem really happy together, don't they? Have I told you about Anthony's plan for the house? She wants the whole place redoing. She's even talking about getting a downstairs loo.
What for? For Mike the cripple?
Don't say that. It's horrible.
It's true, though, isn't it? Why else would we be getting a downstairs bog? It's for me, in case I don't recover.
But you will, and I'm going to make sure of it.
Oh, and how are you going to do that? By buying me a few stupid magazines. Do you really think I want to read about overpaid divvy footballers while I'm lying here not able to walk? Talk about rubbing it in.
Sorry, I thought you'd like them.
You might as well buy me Wheelchair Monthly or something.
Thanks, Clint. Was she good?
Of course she was. Look, I'm going to get off now.
Thanks for the lift.
No problem. Just let us know if you need bringing in again.
You might as well go back with Clint.
I'm fine here. We'll stay till the end of visiting.
No, go on. Don't be staying here for the cripple's sake. It'll save you the hassle of getting the bus. Go on.
All right, then. I will.
If you do decide to stay, I'll make sure that you don't regret it. I mean everything that I've said. Whenever you need me, I'll be here.
If things don't work out, we'd have to go.
But they will. So, will you stay?
You certainly are a persuasive woman. How can we leave someone who cares so much about us?
You won't regret it.
Well, I hope not.
Look, I hope you know what you're letting yourself in for, because it's not going to be easy around here.
After the way things finished between me and Susanna, I feel like I want to make amends, and helping you and the kids will do that.
Good, because I don't want you regretting getting involved or resenting us.
I know, and I won't. Right, listen, I'm sorry, but I've arranged to meet Robbie in Bev's bar, so...
Okay. I could do with a drink myself. Okay if I come?
Yeah, sure.
Good. Give me a chance to break the news to Lance.
You all right?
Yeah, I'll be okay.
Hey, what's up?
Mike. I hate seeing him like that.
He's going to get better, though.
It's like he doesn't want it. He's given up already. He'd rather just lie there and moan. He's turning into his dad.
He's only just coming to terms with the accidents.
I try and get him to be positive, but he just looks at me like I'm pathetic.
Give him time.
What if he gives up completely? He'll never recover. And what am I going to do then?
Hiya. Oh, listen, I'm sorry I'm late.
What's he doing with you?
Well, he's come out for a drink. Well, I could hardly tell him to stay at home, could I?
So, you're all packed and ready to go, then?
Actually, I've decided to give it another go. I'm staying.
Are you sure?
Yeah, positive. Oh, Mick.
Hi, Max.
Just a man. I was wondering if the offer of that job was still going.
I thought you were getting off.
Change of plan.
Yeah, sure.
Coran will work something out.
Thanks.
No.
So what's with the sudden change of heart?
Well, I suppose he's decided to stay for Harry and Emma's sake.
It's nothing to do with you, then?
Of course not.
So you didn't try and talk him out of it?
No, of course not. Anyway, how could I have?
I don't know, but I'm making a lot of stupid promises.
Don't be daft. He just realised he was making a mistake. Not to do with me, honest.
£5,000 he's taking me for.
What?
do anything to get her to leave me alone. I'd be more worried about her leaving me dad alone.
I am not even the slightest bit interested in Max Vaughn.
I must have lost at least a pint of blood.
You listen to me, Beverly McLaughlin. I've heard you spout some rubbish over the years, but that's the biggest load yet.
Martin Sheen stars as the President of the USA in a brand new drama here on 4. The West Wing begins tomorrow at 10 o'clock. Well, next on 4, Embarrassing Illnesses examines disorders of the breast that can affect men as well as women.
Mac's having a little birthday party for Emma, so I'm just wrapping the prezzies. Hey, do you fancy coming?
Nah, you're all right.
Oh, come on.
Why did he decide to stay anyway?
Well, I've told you, because he realised it was for the best.
Yeah, well, you talked him into it more, like.
No, I told him that I didn't want him to take Harry away, but it was his decision not to go.
Yeah, well, I reckon you had more to do with it than you cracking on. I reckon it was down to you practically begging him to stay.
No, it wasn't. He just realised that he'd be better off here.
Better for you or them?
Well, both. Has I lost touch with Harry? Have they gone?
Is that the only reason?
Yeah. Robbie, what's this all about?
Nothing. I'll just forget about it.
Can't you at least pretend to look busy?
Oh, he's upset, isn't he?
Fred.
He's the saddest boy in the whole of Brazil.
He's still missing you madly.
It's getting worse. Don't know how we're going to cope.
Oh, I'm sure you'll find a way. Now, come on, put it away. I don't want you standing there moping. The customers want to see a smiley, happy Lance.
OK. Oh, is it still all right if we go to little Emma's party later?
Yeah, I suppose so, as long as it's not too busy. Might do you the world a good. Take your mind off lover boy in Rio.
Do we have to go to the party?
Yeah. Little Emma would be heartbroken if Auntie Leon didn't turn up.
But it's that house, Lance, that gives me the creeps.
It's just your imagination.
Yeah, well, I don't care what you say. I want to just stay away.
Yeah, well, we're going, and that's final.
Well, what are we going to do about a present for her? We're skint.
Well, I've already got her something. I couldn't resist it. I seen a lovely little outfit in TJ's.
Lance, we haven't even got this month's rent, and you're splashing out on kids' clothes.
It wasn't that much.
Yeah, but more than we can afford.
Anyway, have you come up with any ideas how we can raise some money?
I'm working on it.
We haven't had it off in ages.
Apparently. The last time they did, according to Jackie, Jimmy was hardly the caring lover. In fact, I think he was far from it.
Oh, no wonder she's looking for a bit of hot girl on girl if Jimmy isn't delivering.
It's not just the sex, Bev. The whole marriage is a sham. Seems to me like they're just going through the motions.
Well, what do you expect, eh? I mean, she's an apprentice leather and he's away with the fairies. No offence.
Not taken.
Cheeky cow. She just turned up at the hospital cracking on. She was a friend of the family.
Well, she's no friend of mine.
But your dad was actually made up to see her. You know, he thinks it was really kind of her to visit him.
Well, why would you think any different?
The only reason she went there was to find out what she could about me. And from the sounds of it, he really opened up to her. I thought it was all over.
I told you what she was like.
What am I going to do about it?
Well, there's not much you can do. Well, apart from warning her off.
I've tried.
Well, you're going to have to keep on trying. Mum, she'll end up causing more trouble.
Do you think I should have a word with Bev?
And do you think that'd do any good?
Well, Shelley might listen to her.
I doubt it.
Do anything to get her to leave me alone.
Well, if I was you, I'd be more worried about her leaving me dad alone. Who knows what she could tell him?
What time are you two off to Max Farnham's?
Oh, I'm trying to get out of it.
Well, why don't you want to go?
It's that Max, Bev. I don't trust him.
Why not?
Well, I reckon he knows an awful lot more about Susanna's death than what he's cracking on.
I can't see how.
Well, it's obvious, isn't it? He did it in.
Oh, come off it. How could he do that? He was watching a video with Lance.
Well, I don't know, do I? But I reckon he's got a lot to do with Susanna snuffing it.
Max Farnham would not kill a flea. He's a total wimp.
Yeah, and that's what he wants us all to think, isn't it? But I'm not fooled one bit, Bev. I reckon that if you had a really good root around, we'd find that he's got all sorts of policies out on Susanna.
Well, that's where you're wrong. Because they're divorced, aren't they? He wouldn't get a penny. You're watching too many films. Look, it was an accident. End of story. I don't know what goes on in your head sometimes.
Get us to get some supplies. I've run out of chocolate and I've still got half an essay to do.
Oh, my head's shook. I feel like I've just sat through the longest lecture in history.
Don't exaggerate.
Oh, I'm telling you. I thought it wasn't going to end.
Listen, I'll catch you back at the house, all right? Do you want anything?
No, thanks. I'm all right. Oh, do you fancy going to town tonight? I could do with a good night out.
I've got loads of work to do.
Oh, come on.
Another time, yeah.
Oh, see yourself then. I'm going to give Bernie a ring, see if she'll come out with me.
Yeah. Yeah.
What's the hurry?
No, I've just got loads of energy, that's all.
Oh, lucky Nicky.
Could be lucky you if you're not doing anything tonight.
Sorry, I'm busy.
All right. Can't you blow it out?
Well, I could, I suppose, but I don't want to. See ya.
Right, well, I'm going to go round to Max's. Are you sure you won't come?
No, you're all right. I wouldn't want to get in the way.
What is all this about?
Would you tell me?
Why are you being like this about Max?
Because you're always around there fussing over him.
Only because of my son.
Yeah, well, you sure it's not the father you're interested in?
What? Oh, that is just mad.
Oh, is it, yeah? Well, have you got yourself a ready-made family lined up? Especially now his ex-wife's out the way.
What are you talking about?
It all adds up, doesn't it? Your son's around there with good-looking, available Mr. Smooth.
I am not even the slightest bit interested in Max Farnham.
You might be saying that now. You might even believe it. But are you sure he isn't exactly what you want?
So, are you settling in the flat yet?
Yeah, mind you. Anyway, it would be great after living with Ron.
Must be a bit crowded, what with Victoria, Darren and Jackie. Can't be room to swing a cat.
Oh, it's fine. What'd you do with this?
Bin it. I'm glad we're quiet this afternoon. I could do with leaving early.
You got something on later?
I might have.
A date?
Just going for a drink with this guy.
What's he like?
Gorgeous.
Where'd you meet him?
At the Lomax after this gig. I was just at the bar having a drink and he came up and gave me his number as he was leaving.
And you rang him for a date?
Yeah.
Even though you hadn't spoken to him?
Why not?
He might be a complete divvy.
Oh, well, he's good looking and he's got good taste in music, so he can't be that bad.
You hope?
Look, if he's as promising as he looks, he could be in for a good night.
What should I do about this?
What is it?
It's that memo about Susanna Morrissey when she left Dad in surgery in tears.
I'd forgotten about this. I still don't know what went on.
She seemed dead upset. And the blouse was all ripped.
Mm. What do you think happened?
Don't know.
I suppose we never will either unless we ask Darren.
Should I file it or what? Bin it then?
No, not yet. Let me have a think about this.
Just off to Little Emma's party.
Okay.
Shouldn't be too long. And you know where we are if you need us. Is everything okay? Beth?
Why have I been so stupid?
What's happened?
Dave Lousy Burns, that's what. Don't the robin get. £25,000 he's taken me for.
What?
Just had the accountants on. They've added it all up. What a mug. Fall for it.
He won't get away with it.
But he already has, hasn't he? I'm not going to call the police, am I? And even if they do catch up with him, humiliation would be too much to bear.
He'll get what he deserves, somehow.
Do you know what really hurts me? I loved him. I'd have given him the stupid money if he'd have asked me.
And it's better you find out sooner rather than later. Imagine if you'd have married him.
That's all I ever wanted.
You'll soon forget about Dave Burns. You'll look back and you'll wonder why you were even bothered.
What if I never find anyone else?
You will. You've got too much to offer. What man could hope before for those eyes, eh? Or that personality?
But I found myself dead.
You will do. Someone who really deserves you. A man you can trust with your money and your heart.
You think so?
Of course.
Like you found with Fred.
Right, don't stop me. I'll be blubbing next.
Look, I know it's the other side of the world, but at least you've got someone.
Yeah, and I've decided I'm going to get him over here, no matter what I have to do.
Good for you. The more happiness around here, the better.
I can't believe you even think that I'm slightly interested in Max.
So what do you expect, the amount of time you spend with him?
With Harry?
Yeah, well, as far as I'm concerned, they're the same thing, and I come way below them on your list of priorities.
Of course you don't.
Oh, so I'm just imagining all, am I?
Yeah, you must be.
I'm going to the party, you can do what you want.
See, you're running off there again.
It's a kid's party.
It's you playing happy families more like. Well, I tell you what, Max is welcome to you. They both are.
It's your one, not Max or anyone else.
Yeah, well, that's not how it looks to me.
Are you sure you're going to be OK?
Yeah, you go to the party, I'll be fine.
Oh.
Bev, Jackie Corkill wants a word with you.
OK. Well, you two better get off. You don't want to miss the jelly and ice cream.
I'll see you later.
I wonder who the kids' entertainer is. Probably Freddy Krueger.
Hey, what can I do for you?
Can I have a word?
OK, but I can't say I'm the best company today. Well, if you've come to ask if you can move in with Shelley, that's fine by me. I'm totally open-minded.
Don't joke about this, Bev. It's not funny.
Oh, I'm serious.
Yeah, well, whatever Shelley may have told you, there's nothing between me and her, and there never has been either.
Whatever you say.
I just need you to have a word with her for me.
Don't be getting me involved.
I just want you to ask her to stay away from me and my family.
Have you not tried asking her yourself?
Of course I have, but you won't leave us alone.
Oh, come off it, Jackie. Shelley's not a stalker.
She even went into hospital to see my Jimmy yesterday.
Well, that was nice of her.
No, it isn't. It's sly and devious.
It seems to me that what you're really worried about is Shelley telling Jimmy the truth about what you are.
And what's that?
A closet job?
You listen to me, Beverly McLaughlin. I've heard you spout some rubbish over the years, but that's the biggest load yet. I am normal. I'm not remotely interested in Shelley or any other woman for that matter. Do you understand me?
It's not what Shelley thinks.
Yeah, well, she's living in some fantasy world, isn't she? The sooner she snaps out of that, the better.
So, did she imagine you two sleeping together?
We spent the night in the same bed, but nothing happened, Bev.
Let's face it, Jackie. Shelley is one hell of a catch.
What are you talking about?
Maybe you should take a long, hard look at yourself and stop hiding from your true feelings.
I know what I am. I know who I am.
I reckon you're in denial.
I am not a lesbian. No matter what Shelley says, I'm not.
Looking for someone else?
Nope. Just a magazine.
What exactly are you playing at, Shelley?
How do you mean?
We're going in to see me dad. Hanging round here in a hope to see me mum. Look at you. You're pathetic.
And you're paranoid. I went to see your dad because I happened to like him. And he seemed really pleased to see me. And considering I only live across the road, where else am I going to shop?
Keep away from me mum and dad.
If that's what your mum wants. And I will.
Where have you been?
Sitting on the stairs, wishing never opened my big mouth.
Look, I've known Max Farnham for years, and there has never been anything between us other than friendship. And all right, yeah, I'll admit, I am worried about him, but only as a mate and because he's the father of my son.
I'm sorry.
Don't you realise that I'm mad about you.
I just got into my head that they were more important to you than I am.
Nothing or no one even comes close to you.
You still going to that party then?
No. I'd rather stay here with you instead.
I must have lost at least a pint of blood.
Oh, I don't think it's that bad.
I bet you don't need stitches, the little git.
I'm sure he didn't mean it.
Of course he did. Jackie Dixon's son, isn't he?
Oh, I never thought of that.
And I never saw him hitting anyone else over the edge with a baseball bat, did you?
It was a kid's round as battle, Leanne, and it was plastic.
So it still split my head open, didn't it?
Let's have another look.
I bet your Harry's inherited it in his genes. Ow! He's got a built-in urge to attack me.
I think it stopped bleeding anyway.
Oh, Lance. Score for life.
I know, and we better get it checked out just in case.
Look, Jackie, Shelley isn't soft. If she thought there was nothing down for her, she wouldn't be wasting her time.
Well, that's what she is doing, and she's causing misery for everyone.
Looks like you can tell yourself.
Hi, Jack.
Hey. I want you to leave me and my family alone.
Oh, you're not so mad at me, are you, for visiting Jimmy? How is he, by the way?
You're not interested in Jimmy. You only went there to find out what you could.
It's just not true.
He's very vulnerable at the moment, but that didn't stop you using him, did it?
I genuinely went to see how he was. Why are you being so horrible?
I told her it was all in her imagination.
Well, you might be able to fool this soft cow, but you don't fool me. I'm starting to see what you're really like now. Just leave us alone, shall we?
I could be bleeding to death for all these, Kay.
It seems to have stopped. You should be all right now. Listen, I'll have to get back to work. Will you be okay?
Hopefully.
Oh, you poor love. I wish you could stay.
Come on, don't worry about me.
Hey, make sure you look after her.
Foul over there. I'm off to meet my date.
And we'll have a good time and be good.
Oh, I will. If he's lucky.
Oh, leash.
What should I do about this?
Oh, I can't see any point in keeping hold of it. It's not like she's going to follow it up.
True. But we don't know what happened. He might have touched you down her up or anything.
Yeah, but what can we do about that now?
Nothing, I suppose. I tell you what, though, Darren was lucky it wasn't some money-grabbing sky. He could have ended up suing him for thousands.
Yeah, well, it wasn't. And as far as I can see, it's all over with.
What should I do with it then, Binny?
No, that's hardly a good procedure. Fire that way properly. I'll see you tomorrow.
See ya.
Come into town with us.
Look, I said I'll have one of you. Would you do it?
Can't you work, wait?
It's not just that. I don't feel like it.
You're boring, you.
Don't be taking it out on me just because Barry doesn't want to go with you either.
Yeah, well, I don't want to go out on you. Sure, you want to have one more drink?
I'm okay.
What are you looking so fed up about?
Nothing.
Oh, you can go to Exeter Tiff, have you?
Look, just mind your own business, will you?
Hi, Nick.
This is Anne. Hi, Nick. Hi, Sarah. Hi,
Sarah. Not exactly Mr.
Cheerful, is he? What's upset him?
He's right, down. You are miserable.
Look, I'm all right.
You could have fooled me.
Look, all right. I'll come to town with you.
Brilliant.
Okay, well, I know.
Thanks. I take it your trip to Bev's wasn't a success, then?
Shelley's got to convince there was something to it, or...
Well, there was.
Oh, don't you start.
What exactly do you want me to say, Mum? You spent the night with her. You brought all this on yourself.
I know that. But it doesn't mean to say I've got to stand around and see my whole life ruined because of it. Your dad's due home from hospital any day, isn't he? It's going to be hard enough helping him get back to normal without all this going on.
So what are you going to do about it?
Try and keep Shelley away from him for a start.
Well, knowing what Shelley's like, you're going to have to. Or you could be in real trouble.
Hey, have you seen that Misha over there?
Yeah.
Looks like she's got herself a fella.
It might just be a mate.
As if. It's a first date, you can tell by the body language. They're both trying to impress each other.
Whatever.
Oh, she's really nice here, isn't she?
She's okay, yeah.
Think she's nice looking?
Listen, shouldn't we be making a move?
There's no rush.
I'm not sitting here all night spying on people. Are we going into town or what?
Yeah, okay.
I'm just gonna go for a rest. Misha?
Jerome.
Is that your new mate, is he?
Could be if he plays his cards right.
Who is he?
Did you have sex with Nicky last night?
You what?
Oh, sorry, that's none of my business, is it? Just like me and Andy are none of yours.
I was only asking.
Well, don't, and I won't ask about you and Nicky. And that way we can still stay mates, can't we? See ya.
See ya.
Hey, what did the doctor say?
The way she spoke to me, you'd think it was just a scratch. But she didn't see the blood spurting out of it.
Well, at least you're not going to have a scar.
Well, I am, in the airline, thanks to that, Harry. Do you know, I reckon he's got 3 sixes on his scalp, the little git.
What has our luck been like lately, eh? Can't even go to a kid's party without one of us ending up getting injured.
Yeah, well, our luck will soon change, because I've got an idea how to get some cash.
Huh?
Just you leave it to me.
So you're going to promise me that that's the last of your mad theories about me and Max Farnham?
I'm sorry. It'll never happen again. Should we forget about it over?
Yeah, that's fine by me.
The more she denies it, the more I am convinced Jackie Corkill is a lesbian.
Why won't she just accept it and come out?
Well, it's not as easy for women of her generation as ours, is it? Especially being married with a family.
Yeah, I know. But she'll never be happy.
She's just scared about Jimmy finding out more than anything else. That's why she kicked off over you going to see him. She thought you were going to tell him.
As if I would.
You're going to miss you when you go back to Spain.
I know, I'm dreading leaving you behind.
Isn't there anywhere I can get you to stay?
Is that what you really want?
Yeah. Of course it is, more than anything.
We haven't told each other how we feel.
It's obvious, isn't it?
No, but I don't know how you really feel about me.
Robbie, I love you.
It's the first time you ever told me that.
I think it's the first time I've said it to anyone. I really meant it.
Good. Because I love you too. No, I really love you. You won't let me down, will you?
Jimmy's home. I just thought I'd spruce myself up.
I only got the Christmas takings.
He'd been cooking the books for months, Rachel. All she's got left is the tat that she's standing in.
Look, I'm telling you, something is going on.
It's not about you.
Right, so I am being paranoid.
The practice nurse will be with you shortly.
I want to see Dr. Roebuck.
Catch up with The Week in Brookside in tomorrow's Omnibus at 5:05. And don't forget that tomorrow night at 9, Graham Norton counts down the nation's 100 greatest TV ads. Next tonight, will a Glasgow guy go goofy on his date? Stay tuned for Street Mate.
If that's someone else come home to nursemaid me, I'll scream.
You're being paranoid.
What are you doing home, Tilly? I'm on a prop, Jackie. I'm having a mare.
Any chance of that in English?
Me play? Yous are coming, aren't you?
I'm coming, but your mum's a bit...
Of course we are.
Di, I was only
trying... Save it, Marty. You bore me rigid.
Oscar winning, isn't she? Full slap, show must go on. You've got to give it to her, haven't you?
What do you mean?
Well, to a point you could say that it's just money. But 25 grand? Dave Baird's one stringing up.
He only got the Christmas takings.
He'd been cooking the books for months, Rachel. All she's got left is the tat that she's standing in.
That'll do.
Come on, mate.
Hi, mate. How are you? Oh, it's brass monkeys here, isn't it? I bet that school's like an icebox, is it?
That's him for good now.
One day at a time, love. No. Got a care plan and everything, you know.
I'm made up for you, Jim.
Cheers.
I really am.
Hey, so you got a new addition to the Murray household, eh?
Dad.
No, I meant your porch. I'm sorry, mate. I meant your porch.
Are you all right, Jim? Yeah, it was our Christie's brilliant idea. Must have put at least a fiver on the value of the house. Anyway, I'll see you.
I don't believe I said that.
It's okay, Dad.
Ah, oh, cheers, Ears.
2.5 hours, I'm impressed.
Don't be. Do you fancy going to the pictures tonight?
I promised some of the lads from uni that I'd go for a drink with them.
Where you going?
I don't know, Magnet, I suppose. Anyway, I'm off the gym.
Oh, you make me feel guilty.
Come with me, then.
Not that guilty.
You may as well cancel that membership. It's a total waste of money.
No, I am going to start going.
Yeah, yeah.
Anyway, I can't go now. I should exercise in a full stomach.
Yeah. I was just coming over to your place.
Oh, snap. Milk and biscuits.
Curly perm.
Cheek. Jimmy's home. I just thought I'd spruce myself up.
Oh, it must be lovely to have him back safe and sound.
Yeah. No thanks to the friendly doctor, though.
You don't race him?
I don't race any of them. It's like the blind leading the blind. He was neither use nor ornament with Jimmy, you know, just kept fobbing me off.
Something that serious.
Next thing, Jimmy's on the roof.
Unbelievable. He could have recommended us for fertility treatment ages ago, but he kept stalling and we fell for it.
Talk's a good game, doesn't it?
Well, it might have made any difference, but I'll always wonder.
Makes you lose your faith in them, doesn't it? I mean, I know they're only human, but...
He's more human than most. What about him and Susanna Morrissey? I think I'll take my custom elsewhere next time.
Yeah, me and all. Hey, I should make that appointment.
I could fit you in the savvy.
Good. Shouldn't you be in there doing some work?
You'll have to go to casualty, sir. Yeah, but be really careful not to knock it. You could perforate your eardrum. No, because they'll have to x-ray you, and as I've explained, we don't have those facilities here, OK? Don't mention it.
None of the cotton bud.
Answered his mobile. Forgot it was in his ear.
Oh.
Would you like to go through, Mrs. Stack? Is this medical or social?
Purely social.
Hi, this is Katie Rogers from Manapog Medical Centre.
I was thinking I might come round tonight with a bottle of wine.
Oh, I'm out with the girls tonight, I'm sorry.
How are you?
Am I out?
You soon? maybe some other time then.
Tomorrow? Maybe.
Two post-it.
Thanks a lot.
I'm hungry.
Well, I can't see why. You took a chunk out of Anna Mason's arm.
I remember when Catherine Godfrey bit our lance.
Oh, did your mum go ape, did she?
Nah, she was too interested in a brandy and coke.
Well, what happened?
Well, I went round there the next day and bit the little cow till I drew blood.
Can I have a coke?
Of course you can.
No, you can't. You're in naughty corner. You can have soup and water.
So who's this then?
Granddad Ron.
What's he carrying under his arm?
His head.
How's Mike?
He's getting there. It's gonna be a long haul.
Tricky thing, the spine.
I'm glad I've seen you. Only, you know that video gear? Well, Mike's gonna be in a wheelchair for months.
Yeah, bummer. Still, he'll clean up when he's mobile.
Yeah, but in the meantime, we're just about keeping our heads above water.
Yeah, well, I'd like to help you, love.
Oh, couldn't you buy it back? Or find another buyer?
You're joking, aren't you? That stuff depreciates quicker than cars. You'd be lucky to get a course of what Mike paid for it.
I see.
Come on, cheer up. It's not all doom and gloom. He'll pay for himself 100 times.
Not while he's in a wheelchair, it won't.
So, how's it feel to be home?
Thanks. Well, to be honest, that's why I've come round.
I knew there'd be a catch. Go on.
Well, it's Jackie and Lindsay. It was the same at Christmas.
How do you mean?
Well, they're cold with each other. You know, polite.
Right. Well, it doesn't sound like either of them.
Yeah, I don't know. At first, I thought it was me. You know, dosed up to the eyeballs, paranoid. Thought I was imagining things.
But now?
Well, now I reckon I've cracked it. It's you.
So you said I couldn't have one?
Yeah, well, I clocked your sad little face. Why did you bite, Anna?
Who started it?
Me. Did Dave think I was a meth?
Dave? Oh, we thought you were the bifters.
Got off, though, didn't he? Never said trawr and nothing.
It was me he wanted to get away from, not you.
So why didn't he say goodbye, then?
Because he was in a hurry and because he wasn't as nice as we thought he was.
So, looks like it's just me and you now, eh? Do you reckon we'll cope?
I've got no one to play with.
Yes, you have. You've got me and Lance, little Beth.
I reckon Jackie can't bear it that her only daughter's, you know, gay.
I think she's failed somehow as a mother, you mean?
Well, to be honest.
Well, I think we can give Jackie a little more credit than that, Jim.
Look, she can't get her head round you and Linz. You know, you and Linz.
I doubt that.
Well, what else can it be?
I don't know. Mothers and daughters are notoriously complicated.
Look, I'm telling you, something is going on.
And I'm sure that whatever it is, Jim, it's not about you.
Oh, right, so I am being paranoid. And I thought I was doing okay.
You are, Jimmy. You're doing brilliantly.
Look, there is something wrong. Either it's real or it's in my head.
Jimmy.
Thanks for the tea.
Look, don't let anything knock you off kilter. Do you hear me?
The word of a lie, Beth. The pain travels from here, right up to here.
It was right as rain before.
But if it hasn't cleared up by tea time, I'm going to have to make a visit to the docks.
Right.
I feel dead sorry for him.
Oh, no. He misses Dave. He thinks it's all his fault.
I'd like to punch his lights out. I would. Not so funny.
You clown. Oh, I'm down 25 grand and I'll get really, really cross.
So it was 25,000.
Here's me, dreaming of having his kid. All the time he's dreaming of getting off. Hey ho.
Same again, love.
That really, and obviously, you know, it comes. I mean, I think it's
Jackie.
Hospital.
As
you
know, I do. Listen, take care. Jackie, wait.
think we should clear the air.
Consider it cleared, excuse me. Well, what about a drink after work?
No, thanks.
I need to talk to you. It's important.
Jimmy's own.
I know.
Want to cook him a nice meal and make a fuss of him.
Well, I think he needs a bit more than a pan of scouse.
Why don't you patronise someone else?
I didn't mean it like that. Jackie, a drink. One drink?
You always make everything sound so innocent.
No, that's your forte. Black, white, straight, gay, something, nothing. Jimmy suspects.
What?
He's on the case. And I haven't told him anything.
6:30. In there.
Thank you.
New home.
Should we risk the homemade wine?
No chance. I need this like a hole in the head.
Me too. She spent 3 months writing it. Saw Max before.
Did you speak to him?
Yeah. He's gone back to the restaurant. Getting on with things, you know.
And I've gone back to the salon getting on with things.
I know you have.
It's not a competition, Marty.
What time are you going out?
I'm not.
Been blown out?
Nope. Blown away.
You smooth cat.
Get your cocoa, love, because you're pulled.
Mike will be waiting for me.
You've been on your feet all day.
Which is more than could be said for your life.
I thought you were ill.
I am. Bev!
Oh, it's medicinal. It'll help you sleep.
Favouritism is a terrible thing, you know, Beverly.
Well, you don't want to go to the docks stinking like a brewery, do you?
Well, I reckon it's me reproductive bitch, you know.
Oh, thanks again for the running commentary. You've really kept me going. He's blaming himself. Questioning his own sanity.
Well, he doesn't know Carly, is he?
Rubbish. It's hurting him every day. It's there between you. Between us.
He said you wanted to clear the air.
Isn't love about being honest? With ourselves, with our loved ones.
Is that another veil, Stress?
No. You have your version of events, and I have mine.
I have the truth.
Oh, that's a darn sight more than Jimmy's got.
Nothing happened.
Then why don't you tell him precisely that?
You know why. It's a destroyer. He's just about on an even keel now.
Then just explain to him that it was nothing. It meant nothing.
Trying to trick me into saying it did mean something. Oh, well, all right then. Yeah, it did.
If God is our landlord and we be earth tenants, surely eviction will come as our penance. German Shepherd, Alsatian, vivisection sweeps the nation. As smoking beagles fill laboratories, cold-hearted murderers make their oratories.
The dogs want walkies, their slayers tell porkies. From the loins of cows come three-headed sows.
From the lungs that were pink, now gunky and stink.
Ears on mice, men on Mars, stinking pollution from diesel-fueled cars.
A passion for fashion and feeling the chill. Bludgeon the blighter, go in for the kill.
That's what friends are for.
Shelley, in the great scheme of things, against 25 years of marriage, it didn't mean anything.
Jackie, you were unfaithful to him. I held you all night.
Now you hold me to ransom.
Truth can be liberating. Until you come clean, you and Jimmy are a lie. I mean, what you have is a lie.
No, we're back on track.
You see, that's not how he sees it.
I'm going to make my marriage work.
Feel guilty about cheating on him. Jackie, Jimmy needs to love all of you, even the part of you that cheated on him. The part that you're hiding from him.
What was that for?
I just felt like it. You're one of the strongest people I know.
Good job, really, considering how many times I've been dumped on.
Well, I won't want to be in Dave's shoes when you catch up with him.
Don't worry about that. You can get some really fancy footwear for 25 grand, you know.
Go and get it back. I mean, how dare he treat you like that and upset Josh like that?
He's gutted.
So do something about it. Take a leaf out of Josh's book and bite back. See ya.
The practice nurse will be with you shortly.
I want to see Dr. Roebuck. If you let the nurse assess you, it could save you waiting.
Listen, love, I'm not being funny, but you can tell Nurse Susan to go practice the bandages on her dollies, OK?
I'm in pain here.
Nurse Batra is very experienced. Nothing phases her.
Oh, isn't that nice? But I'd rather stick with the organ grinder all the same.
A kennel, a hutch, a warren, a den. These are our sanctuaries away from you men. Cocker spaniel, border collie. Stop this barbarism, you know it. Folly.
Hold on. Shh. No, we shouldn't laugh. She went so hard.
It was awful, that was.
Fancy some fish and chips on the way home.
I just feel really compromised, Jackie.
Don't stick your nose in there.
Jimmy came to see me, remember?
And aren't you just loving every minute of it, eh? You know, if you really cared about me...
What? I'd leave you alone.
Please.
I do care about you, so I can't. Put your relationship to the test and tell Jimmy about our night together.
I can't.
Find out what your marriage is really made of, Jackie. Live the truth, and then you'll know what you want.
I want Jimmy.
Oh, but Jimmy might not want you. And I think he has a right to know about you and me. I'm not going to live a lie forever.
What can I say?
What?
That.
What about it?
Don't be fishing for compliments. It was different though, wasn't it?
I don't know.
It was. You ain't holding back.
It was great, but it's always great.
Yeah, but I always felt like you held back. Well, because of the rape, you were extra careful with me.
Right.
And I loved you for it, for your tenderness.
Are you okay?
Never better.
I sat here that long, I think I'm grown and muzzy. So the whole point of these places is that you drop in and get seen to, not drop in and drop off.
Thank you, Doctor.
All the best.
The doctor will be with you shortly, Miss Powell.
Just hope he's worth waiting for.
She said she wants to write a piece per term.
We'll have to camcorder the next one. Give us a bit of your card.
Would you like some of your own?
Which I get. Sorry.
No, you're all right. I was stuffed anyway.
I've been a total cow. Nice to everyone else and taking all my badness out on you.
It's called being married, doesn't it?
It hardly seems fair, though, does it? I do love you. Even though your daughter is a complete head the ball.
Hey, mind me porch.
Yeah.
Hope your dad doesn't go tell them any ghost stories.
They're fine.
I did. And do you know what she said to me? She said, don't worry.
I saw Shelley today.
Any more vain than you already are.
I wondered why your dad did it all. I wanted to look nice for your dad.
Oh, thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. You're a lovely audience. And we're going to have some
you're
real
joking.
Fun tonight.
I know. Maybe you should go out and sleep with someone. One of my exes, maybe that'll show him.
Oh,
you already
are.
I said I saw Shelley.
I'm not interested in
you. Don't you look nice. What do they call this outfit then? A t-shirt?
Your dad's been to see her. She reckons he knows.
About nothing, you mean?
She said that he's aware that things aren't right between you and me. And she thinks he's got a right to know.
And what's the worst that can happen?
Dad, it's the roof. Again. And the pavement. She said if I don't tell her, she will. Not in so many words, like, I mean, a bit fancier than that.
Sounds to me like you're going to have to come clean.
Are you serious?
Well, Shelley's a loose cannon, isn't she? I mean, the only reason she hasn't already told me, Dad, is because she still thinks there's a chance for you and her.
Don't.
And once that penny drops, Mum, she'll want to wreck your life. And as much as we know, it'll hurt me, Dad. Deep down, we both know he deserves the truth. Whatever that is. Right, I'm off. I'll see you tomorrow.
Okay, see you tomorrow.
Bye.
Right, if you just want to hop up on there, I'll take a look.
Okay, thanks, bye.
Leanne, what's happened? What's going on?
I wish I knew. One minute she's sitting there telling me her symptoms, the next she's screaming her head off. She runs out the door.
He groomed me!
Stop worrying about it.
Why is Leanne Powell targeting me?
Where did he touch you?
In one of them little rooms around the back?
No, I mean, where exactly?
And then it's my fault.
What is?
The baby.
Like, I'm really worried.
Lizzie, what's up?
That Christy won't buy the video stuff back.
Are you joking?
I don't think we're going to be able to cope.
And that next Brookside is tomorrow at 8 o'clock. Well, next on 4, Corsa, Yaris and Ignis, the tweenies of the car world, are living it large in Driven.